Hi everyone. In the previous video, we saw how we can use NetworkX package from Python to analyze network datasets. In this video, we are going to learn some basic features of a software called Gephi, which is also used for the analysis and visualization of networks. Gephi is an open source tool which is written in Java. Although NetworkX provides a number of functions to analyze networks, however, when it comes to visualization, Gephi provides much more flexibility. So let's get started and look at the interface of Gephi software. I already have Gephi installed in my system, which is Ubuntu. But in case you want to know how we can do that, I'll quickly show you that. So it's pretty simple. I'll just download Gephi for Ubuntu. So we can follow the first link. So we have to download a file. I'll click this link and yeah, this is the file that we have to download. The version is 0.9.1. So you're going to download this file. After you download it, you wherever you have saved it, you will open the terminal there in that folder, and you'll run this command to extract the Gephi folder out of it. And after that, you will get a Gephi folder extracted out of the file, and you will go inside bin. And after that, you will run /Gephi. That's how you will start the software. So I already have it downloaded in my system. So I am going to show you how we can start it. So I'm going to open the terminal here. Since I'm in Gephi, I'll go to bin and then I write /Gephi. Okay, that's how we start. This is the software. This is the interface of Gephi. We are going to start a new project. So I'll click here. Now, these are the various options. Now, in order to analyze a network in Gephi, we have to first open that the file of that network here. The most commonly used format by Gephi community is .gexf. However, there are a lot of other formats which are also supported in Gephi. For example, let me show you. When you click open here, these are the formats that are supported by Gephi. As you can see, there is CSV, there is GEXF, there is GML, GraphML, .NET, Pagic files. So a number of formats are fortunately supported by Gephi. In this video, we are going to take a small network. We had already downloaded this karate.gml in the previous video. So we are going to continue with that. So I am selecting this file and I'm opening it. So this is what I get. So this is graph type, which is mixed here, since it is not mentioned anywhere what kind of graph it is, whether it is directed or undirected. Since we know that karate is an undirected graph, I'm going to select undirected here. Then it's showing me the number of nodes and edges, and it's not a dynamic graph and it's not a multigraph. I want a new graph, so I'm going to click OK. So as I do that, this is the graph that I get. Let me click here and see more options here. So on this interface, there are a few options on the left hand side, there are a few options on the bottom, there are a few options on the right hand side. My aim is to introduce you to this software so that you can use it for your analysis. So let me quickly start this. On the bottom, you see some options. For example, you can change the background color. So you can always change that in case you want. Then there is this option of zooming. Let me zoom in this network so that I can visualize it better. And then you can go to this edges tab. Here you have this pointer which you can use to increase the thickness of the edges. So I'm going to keep it like this. And then you can go to labels. Basically, I'm telling you the most commonly used features out here. So when you go to labels, and if you click this node, you get the labels of the nodes here. And this is how you can change the size of the labels as well. Now this is not looking so good because the size of the node is very small. We can always change that. I'll show you how we can do that as well. And here, let me show you. You can also display the labels of the edges. in this graph there is no label assigned to the edges, so it is not going to make any difference. So these are the main features available of here. So these are some of the shortcuts that you can use for changing the thickness, and this is for changing the font size of the labels of the nodes. So that was about it. Now let's go to the left hand side panel. So here we have this appearance panel, and under that we have nodes tab and edges tab. So once this nodes tab is clicked, we have some four options over here. The first option is for the color, and second option is for the size. Since we want to change the size of the nodes, so I'm going to show you this first. So right now the size is 10, let me make it 30, let's say, and then I apply, and this is what I see. So the labels have gone. This is because the color of the nodes is black, so we can change that. I'm going to click this color palette, and this is the color which is there by default. We can change it. Let me give some color here, and when I apply, you see the color of the nodes as well as the edges has changed. This is by default. It changes the color of the edges as well. We can change that further. I will show you that. And this is for the color of the labels. Let's keep it black itself as of now. And this is for the size of the labels. Now let's click the edges tab and see what options are here. So we have the color of the edges. Since we have to change it, let's change it to some bluish color and apply, and the color of the edges has changed. Now this is for changing the labels of the edges. Since there are no labels, so it won't make any difference, and this is for changing the size of the labels. All right. Now in the bottom left corner out here, you see an option for changing the layouts. So layouts basically tell us the way the nodes should be positioned, and how the graph should look like. So there are number of layouts over here, and we can change it. You can just play around with them. I'm going to show you one of the layout here which might be useful in certain scenarios. Sometimes what happens that these nodes are overlapping, so one node is hidden behind the other, so that way you cannot see them properly. So I'm going to show you one format that can help in such a scenario. Before that, I have to show you one of the nice features of Gephi, and that is you can manually position the nodes. Now this is something that you cannot do in NetworkX. If you have to change the positioning, you have to write code for that. You cannot simply do this. So this is one of the nice features of Gephi. Now, as I was telling you, sometimes nodes overlap each other. I'm explicitly overlapping some of the nodes so that I can show you the functioning of one of the layouts. So I'm just explicitly putting some nodes on top of the other nodes. So let's go here and see. There is one layout that's called no overlap. So I'm clicking it and I'm running it, and you see the nodes have scattered. The ones which were overlapping, they are no more overlapping. So that's what is the effect of this layout. There are a number of other layouts as well, so you can just read the documentation of these layouts and see what they do. Let's go to the right panel now. On the top you see it just displays the number of nodes, number of edges, and it's an undirected graph. As you go down, you have a number of functions that we can apply on the given network. Now before we get into these functions, I want to show you two things over here. So we are currently working in this overview tab. There are two more tabs on the top left corner. So one of them is data laboratory. Let's see what is there. So here you see the IDs of the nodes and the labels of the nodes, and when you click on the edges, you see all the edges in terms of source and target. So this is the basic information about the network in the form of a spreadsheet. So there are some other features also available over here. For example, you can add new nodes here, you can add edges here, and you can also export this table. So one more feature that should be noted here is that when you apply some sort of operation on the network, the values that will be calculated out of that operation will also be added to this spreadsheet. So once you apply a lot of operations and you want to save the details, you can just export the table, and you can make use of that table in some other tool as well. So that is a nice feature. So let's get back to the overview, and let me show you the third tab as well, the preview tab. When you click this and you press refresh, your network appears over here with a very nice rendering which you can download and use it the way you want. So you can export it in these formats, that is SVG, PDF, PNG. You can also change various properties of this network. For example, if you want to show the labels, you can click here and you can change the forms. After clicking it, you have to press refresh. Now you see the labels here. You can also change the font. For example, let me reduce the font to 8 because it's not looking so nice here. Let me press refresh, and the label has reduced. So you can change it the way you want. There are a lot of other features as well. For example, you want to show the labels or show the edges or not. So of course you want to show the edges. You can just play around with these features, and you can also change the background color. Let me just show you this feature. So this is how you can play around here, and then you can download it and you can use it. Let's go back to the overview tab, and we were checking the functions that Gephi provides here. So we have this function average degree. Let's click on run. So just click a button, and the average degree and a number of other things will be calculated. In this network, the average degree is 4.5, and it has also given us the degree distribution automatically. As you can see, this is a sort of power laws plot, as we observed in the previous video as well. Now you can save this plot, you can copy it, you can print it. So it's up to you how you want to use this information. Once you calculate the degree, there are a couple of more features that you can see on the left hand side. Now let me show you that. So here nodes tab is clicked, and you see one more option here, that is ranking. So sometimes what we want to change the appearance of certain nodes based on certain properties. For example, we want that nodes which have high degree should appear a little different, be it in terms of color or be it in terms of the size of that node. So such features are very easily available in this software. So we have this nodes clicked here, and let me click this color here, and when I click the ranking here, it is asking me how we want to rank the nodes. Now I've selected degree here. After this, when you press apply, you see the colors of the nodes has changed. The nodes which have high degree are darker in color, and the nodes which have less degree are lighter in color. So you can quickly see by looking at the network, you can see which are the nodes that are having the high degree. So this is one visualization feature. Similarly, if you want that the nodes which have high degree should appear bigger in size, so you can also do that. So I'm clicking the this button here, and so as of now the size is unique, that is 30, right? So we want to change it based on degree. So I'll select degree here, and the minimum size is 1 and maximum is 100. I'll go ahead with that. So I'll press apply. So this is what you see. The sizes of the nodes has changed based on the degree. As you can see, there are two three nodes which have very high degree as compared to the other nodes. So accordingly, the size of the node has changed. So this is another nice visualization feature. So that was about degree. Let's check out more features over here. We have average weighted degree. Since this graph is unweighted, so this is not going to make any difference. So we're getting the same average degree here. This is because the weight is 1 for all the edges. We also have a number of other functions here. For example, network diameter, we have density, we have modularity, page rank, connected components, clustering coefficient. So as and when you will learn the other concepts in the throughout the course, you might want to come back here and then analyze your network based on those parameters that you have learned. So that will be nice, because now you see what all features this software provides. So as and when you learn about that feature, you can come back here and then import your graph file and then see the features. So that will be a good start for you. Let's go back here, and yes, I want to show you one more thing here in data laboratory. Since we calculated the degrees of the nodes, that degree has come over here. So another column has been added over here where the degrees of the nodes have been displayed. So you can export this table and you can use it the way you want. If you go to the preview tab, again, if you press the refresh button, you get that network over here. So this is the final rendering of the network, and from the left hand side panel, you can change the various properties of this network. So I think that was a pretty much basic introduction to Gephi software, and maybe a good starting point for you. Thank you.